Hello.
So, this is a review. I got to see a movie I've been wanting to see of one of my favorite actors, and that is
the number 23.
What do the numbers mean?
Everything equals 23. So, this has a, Jim Carrey as one of my favorite actors, as a guy by the name of Walter Sparrow, very cool name, and it's directed by a very well-known director, Joel Schumacher, who did DC Cab, St. Elmo's Fire, The Lost Boys, Falling Down, which was fucking amazing, 8mm, wow, actually own quite a few of these movies that he directed. That's funny. And then later on, 12 Trespass, which is a great Nicolas Cage and Nicole Kidman flick. So he's got a lot of great movies under his belt. And then he is joined by his wife Agatha, who is played by Virginia Madsen, who has been in at least one movie I've seen, probably a few. Wow, she's been in a lot of movies. Over 100. So, yeah, she has been in a lot of horror type of movies, it looks like. She was in The Prophecy. She was in, I'm trying to find one that I know I've seen her in. Oh, she was in Firewall. She was in Father of Invention with Kevin Spacey. The Magic of Belle Isle with Morgan Freeman. This is weird. I know I've seen her in. She was in that new movie, Joy. I don't know. I hate when I fucking see an actor that I know and I'm like, what have I seen them in? And then I look and I'm like, I don't remember seeing any of those. But anyways, it's also got Logan Lerman, who was in Perks of a Wallflower. And he was also Percy Jackson in Percy Jackson and the Lightning Thief, which is a great movie. Mark Pellegrino, who I could have swore, oh, that's right, he was Jacob, which is my name, yeah, in Lost, which was pretty sweet. So, along with several other movies. Okay. And then another actor who, Ed Lauder was also, who's also a quite a well-known, actor. And then, I want to make sure that I'm getting this because, yeah, Tom Lank was also in it. Who had a very small role, but he is Andrew in Buffy. Anyways, so Jim Carrey plays Walter Sparrow, and his wife, it's his birthday, and his wife finds a book called The Number 23. So he starts reading and gets really involved and interested in it, and he's like, this character sounds like me, but the character's name is Fingerling, so why? Oh, and also Walter is a dog catcher, so in this Jim has pretty long hair. Not like this long, but it's like down to the back of his neck. So anyways, he's got the book and he's reading and he's like, Fingerling, why does this sound a lot like me? So he goes and just continues to like become obsessed with the book, essentially. And him and his son are like, oh, blah, 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 my birthday. I was born on February 3rd and, you know, 23 and stuff like that. And just all kinds of crazy stuff. And he found out that the number 23 drove some people to madness and then eventually death. And so he's starting to imagine all this stuff, and the wife is getting kind of worried. Let's just say that the movie's pretty, got a pretty wow ending. But I think Jim did a great job. I'd love to see him in more suspense and horror films. So, yeah, it was a good movie, plus, a good supporting cast, and, interesting concept, very interesting, yeah, so that's, whoa, I just went out of focus, okay, that is the number 23, look at that, that's a cool cover, too, so, pretty interesting, man. I can now say that there are no Jim Carrey films that I've seen that I didn't like. There are still a few I need to see. Man on the Moon, The Majestic, some of his older ones, but that's about it. So, see you guys later.